Does your next experiment involve CCR5? This video is for scientists who want to run Western blot, IHC, flow or other immunoassays against CCR5. We will cover some basic facts, protein expression, and CCR5's expected behavior in Western blot. All information in this video is based on public information and no proprietary experimental evidence was used. Topic 1. Quick facts about CCR5. CC chemokine receptor type 5 or CCR5 is a 7-transmembrane G protein coupled receptor that binds to its specific ligands to mediate cellular signaling. CCR5 is 352 amino acids long and runs about 40 kilodaltons on a Western blot. Topic 2. Where is CCR5 expressed? CCR5 RNA expression is present in the lymphoid tissues, gastrointestinal tract, female tissues, lungs, and some T cells, macrophages, and dendritic cells. You can find more information on proteinatlas.org to check out which cell lines express CCR5 and which ones don't. This information will come in handy when designing positive and negative controls for Western blot and immunohistochemistry. Topic 3. CCR5 in Western blotting. Antibody specificity can make or break an experiment. After looking through Western blot images from publications and antibody companies, we can see that typically one band can be expected in a CCR5 Western blot at around 40 kilodaltons. Check out the PMC link for more images, which is also provided in the description box. Topic 4. Some interesting facts about CCR5. In 1996, CCR5 was found to be an important receptor needed for HIV entry into cells. Since this discovery, CCR5 antagonists have been used as HIV/AIDS therapies. CCR5 is also overexpressed in certain cancer types, such as acute lymphoblastic leukemia, breast cancer, Hodgkin lymphoma, and many other cancer types. CCR5 is being further investigated due to its clinical implications in HIV, AIDS, and cancer research. Thank you for watching, and check out the links and references in the description box below. Let us know in the comments which biomarker you would like us to discuss next. Subscribe to stay tuned for more biomarker videos.